Hello and welcome to another day of Learning Korean with Ray. Day 237. Yeah, yesterday we have completed the grammar and we did the exercise, the only exercise, which was very easy. But yeah, with that we completely finished lesson 25 and now we can go into the test. Let's first check if we have some vocabulary memorized. I did some earlier. Let's see. Maybe I assume we have some more again. And one more. Okay, one one vocabulary review here. Kyolge. What? It's not Kyolge? Okay, then it's I know, it's Kyolguan.
결과.
Kyolgua, okay. Kyolgua, okay. Got it. Oh wait, what did I see there? Flo, very active again. 40,000. Okay, anyways, we have finished lesson 25 now, and we have finished the vocabulary, and now it's time for the test. Welcome to the stream, StarCast TV. Hello, Annyeong, Annyeonghaseyo. Okay, so let's switch to howtostudykorean.com, and now we are checking where the test, it should be here. The test for lesson 17 to 25 here. Ban ban gap sipnida. Pan 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 gap sipnida. Wait, wait, wait. Pan gap da. To something with pleasure, to enjoy something, to yeah, something like that, but I'm not completely sure what Pangap Simnida is. Simnida. Yeah, Simnida is obviously the normal polite conjugation, but I think it's something like something related to pleasure. I'm not quite sure. Hi Flo. Pangawa, yo. What is it? Something like enjoy or so? I don't quite remember, sorry. I have to check it. Oh, what? Okay, I have to say something about this. I know this phrase. Manaso pan ga woyo. Here, this one. This phrase, I know. I know this phrase, okay? I didn't know that this the thing you said is basically a short form of that. I thought this part is just the nice to. Because here in this phrase, you in this verb, you don't have the meeting. Meeting is mana. So that was not here, so I didn't know that it's still nice to meet you. I mean, okay, Flo, you say that's the more polite form, but I mean, this is also the polite conjugation, right? So the bottom part is even more polite than the simnida form. I see, I see. Here, pleasure. It's a pleasure. Glad, happy. Yeah, here, this is what I learned. This is what I learned here. Glad, happy, pleasant, welcome. To be glad to do something or so. This is what I learned. Okay, so we have discussed that. Yeah, exactly, Flo. That's why it's weird. Okay. Anyways, are we ready for the mini test, lesson 17 to 25? I have to say, I think I'm not ready, but we'll do it anyways. I think I'm not that prepared when it comes to lessons. I don't know, 22, 21, and so on. I think I will have some problems there, but we'll do it anyways. Oh, StarCast. All the different forms, okay. Manasaw, Pangab, Simnida. Manasaw, Tedani, Tedani, Pangab, Simnida. What is Tedani? Tedani? Te? Tedani. Oh, wait, I mistyped. Very, to great extent. Okay. Okay, thanks for the information. Extremely. Okay, very, very polite form. Okay, I see. I see. Okay. Don't worry if the test doesn't go so well. This website is here to help you. Let's do it. Test. Mini test. Okay. Here we are. You made it through lesson 17 to 25. Congratulations. Try writing this mini test before you move on to the unit test. Yes. Okay, choose the incorrect usage of the connecting particle go or co. The incorrect. Okay, so three of those sentences are correct and one is not correct. Okay, so I know goshipta and I know goita. Those are the two I know. Chonin Arim Tap Arim Tapta Arim Tapta. What is Arim Tapta? Arim. Kerigo, ja. What is Arim Tapta? Oh my god, I feel like I to should totally know this. Arim. I feel like I've heard this so often already. Arim Tapta. Arim Tap. Ah, beautiful, beautiful. Okay, beautiful. I got it. I got it. All good, all good. Tonin Arim Tapgo Pabelmokos? Beautiful food, but that's weird. It should be Arim Town, Arim Down. Arim Down. Right? That should be correct. Arim Down. Pabil Mokosoyo. So I think this is already wrong, but we'll read the rest. Kinyonin, she. Yep, yep, go. Kiga koyo. Damn it. Pretty. pretty height? I have no idea. I have no idea. I guess I'm missing a usage of this particle. So Flo, you're saying that's a Kerrigo one, but I don't see Kerrigo. Yeah, I know this Kida. Not Kida, wait, Kiga Kida, right? I know this is to be tall, but this is to be pretty, so pretty tall? Pretty and tall? That should be qua, maybe? Okay, it's all two sentences connected. Okay, she's pretty and tall. Okay, so it's just the connecting with and. But I learned, I think I learned wa or and qua for connecting. Do you like a challenge? I will answer the message you sent me in Korean. Okay, sure. Starcast, I'm always up for more. Kerrigo. Okay. I'm beautiful. And I have eaten rice. That's weird. That's a weird thing to say. I still think the first one is incorrect. But okay, let me read what Starcast is writing first. Noe. Küssete. Kessete, Kessete. Ah, okay. Your casting? Your casting? PD. PD onen. PD. What is PD? I am. Again, I feel like I should know this. PD. Don't qu I'm not quite sure. PD Onin. Ah, PDO. PDO video. Oh my god, yes, of course. It's video. Oh man. Really, I need to know this. At least I get it in the end without help. That's good. Your casting video. So Flo, just for your information, since you have no idea what's going on. Starcast sent me some Korean games and I casted them and I created videos for him to upload them to YouTube. So that's the context here. So your casting video. Three days. I don't quite know what Toei is something about in 3 days. So I think I can already know the answer from the context, but I want to understand every single part. Okay, what's the next one? Upload. Uploade. Okay, upload. Okay. Always these English words. Toilgott. Ah, okay. Future Form. Will be uploaded, probably. Something will be uploaded. Your casting video will be uploaded. And what's the last thing? Katzimnida. Kada is to be the same, right? Your casting videos will be. Yeah, so I'm not quite understanding the same part. Maybe they will all be uploaded on the same day in 3 days. Something like that, but I'm not quite sure. I don't understand the 3 day and then toye toye toye. I don't know what that is. Okay, and then next line. Hogan, Hogan, Tuil. No, it's not Tuil, it's Eel. And then again, Doe. I don't know this Doe. It's to become, but I don't understand what it means in this context. I just know Toeda, to become. So is it correct? My casting videos will all be uploaded in 3 days, all at the same time in 3 days. That's the meaning. Okay, I will still put it in the translator now. Whoops. Let's see what the translator is saying. Okay, so I do not understand this part. I do not know what this is. In the next 3 days. Ah, okay, so it's not quite in 3 days, it's in the next 3 days. So it could be in 2 days as well. I see. I didn't know this one. But I also don't understand why this part is here. Yeah, I guess it means something like at the same time, but don't quite get the structure here. To become, yeah. Okay. And now this one. Whoops. Or 2 days later. Okay, so it looks like this one means always like later and the next following later. Interesting. In 3 days? Samilane, 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 Samil Nero, Samil Toe, Samil Hue. Oh, Hue, I know actually. Yeah, who is after? Oh, who? Ohu afternoon. Right? Okay, so I didn't know about this later. But yeah, okay, nice. thanks for the information, Starcast. Or Cruiser. Should I call you Starcast or Cruiser? I'm not sure. Yes. I get the meaning most of the time, but I never understand every single part of the sentence. But I guess it's enough for now. Okay. That's good. So, I would say back to the connecting particle co. So again, I think this first sentence is weird. I'm pretty and I've eaten rice. I mean, it's probably technically correct, but like grammatically, it's correct. It's proper Korean, but it's just a weird thing to say. I'm beautiful and I've eaten rice. It's so weird. Yeah, Flo is really Gosu. Kosu. Okay, she is pretty and tall. This makes sense. Pretty and tall makes sense, okay? This is correct and makes sense. Let's see the na third one. Chonin igosil hago kalkoyeo. I did the thing and I will. I did the thing and I will go? What? This makes also no sense to me. StarCraft slang, yeah. A lot of StarCraft. My Korean streams are always full of StarCraft content. Yeah, what can I do? That's where people know me from. Can't change it. Ray Chobo. Yes, me Chobo. Okay, so again, this one makes also no sense to me. This one made no sense, and but I think it was grammatically correct. This one, however, so I did this thing. And I go, but go where? Maybe go is a verb where you need a destination, so maybe this one is even grammatically incorrect. The first is really hard. I'm curious if you know. What do you mean? You mean the first sentence here, sentence number A? Or do you mean the first task in general? Or exercise. First, okay, so this whole task, okay. Yeah, I mean, I'm saying already this one is a weird sentence, but I think it's correct. And this one seems incorrect so far. But this one I'm most comfortable with saying, yeah, this is correct. She's pretty and tall, makes sense and looks correct. Yeah, this one looks correct but doesn't make sense. This one doesn't look correct and doesn't make sense. I will do this. Ah, yeah, okay, you're right. I will do this. Yeah, I will do this. Yeah, I guess it can. I will go. Yeah, I guess you don't need a destination for to go. That's correct. I'll just go away. I guess I will leave. Leave would be the better verb. For to go, I always expect a destination. I expect I will go home. I will do this and then I will go home, or I do this and then I will leave. But just to say I will go. It seems weird for me, but yeah, I guess it can be correct. Yeah, you're right. Okay, Tonnen Kegosil Chorhago. So, I like that thing. And Igosil Shiroheo. So I like that thing. And I hate or dislike this thing. Okay. Interesting. So, what do I know about this concept? I know that the tense only needs to be in the second part. So here, for example, we have a future form. So we don't need a future form here, because that's totally fine. But this is future anyways, even if we don't see a future conjugation here, because the future conjugation is there. Okay, that's fine. What else do we have? We have the fact that the subject, if it's the same, can be omitted in the second part, which is the case here, for example. Here we have chonin, and here we don't. Here we also have chonin. Here we don't. Okay, what else? What else do I know? Let's look at the subject and object particles. Here we have a subject particle. Here we have an object particle. I know that nin cannot be in both sentences, I think. But maybe I'm mixing something up here, but it's not the case anyways. She Jeppeda is pretty tall. Okay, here we have a gar as this object particle here. Here we have all we have ill as object particle. What else do we have? Here we have past tense. And this is. I mean, still, the first sentence doesn't make sense to me. The first sentence does not make sense to me. I'm beautiful and I'm eating rice. I mean, it can be a correct sentence, but it's weird. They don't fit together, those two sentences. I'm beautiful and I eat rice, or I'm eating. I ate. It's past. I was bu ah okay. I was beautiful, and I ate. That's so weird. Is it even possible to have past tense connected to an adjective? So it's I was beautiful. I mean it, yeah, you can say that, but it's so weird to say. I was beautiful and I ate rice. Or I ate, just I ate. I ate something. I have a bad feeling about the sentence, so my answer would be A. But I can't really pinpoint why. I have like some ideas. The past tense is a bit weird, and the two don't fit together in the same context, but that's not an incorrect usage of the particle. That's just that the sentence doesn't make sense. So I'm not sure if that answer is correct, but I would answer A. Learn Russian, man. No, I'm not learning Russian. Grime Bosarlovsky. Sorry, no Russian here, only Korean. No Rutsky. Okay, you said that C is grammatically correct. Okay, let's see. Is C not grammatically correct? Koyeyo. Okay, we have a future form of to go here. And here we have ha, which is to do. It's fine. Yeah, I don't see a mist I don't see an a problem here in this sentence. Hago. No, I don't see it. Sorry, Flo. So, should I go to back to the lesson and see if I can find the problem? So, should I review the lesson very quickly, like scroll through the lesson quickly and see if I can find the problem, like refreshing my memory about this and then checking it again? Or should we just continue and you give me the correct answer? What's your preference? I think I would go with reviewing the lesson very quickly, but not like a huge long time, but just quickly. And if I can see it in 2 minutes or so, then that's fine. Okay? That was lesson 17, yeah. I read again. Wait, you don't know the answer? I thought you know the answer. I don't know. Oh, okay. That makes me feel better. Okay, then let me read through this very quickly. Okay. Yeah, but it's always weird if they have the correct grammatical usage, but the sentence doesn't make sense. That's not the correct answer for the question, which one is the incorrect usage. Incorrect, I would assume they mean grammatically incorrect and not incorrect in a does it make sense way, right? So that's always a bit weird. Yeah. Okay, so let's see. Maybe I can find something. Go can be attached to thing. Yeah, okay. One action occurs and then something happens after. So that also goes against A. This is not an action occurs and then another action occurs. This is a state. That's an adjective. And then there's a verb, an action. So, again, A seems fishy, okay? Just from this sentence here. Okay, let's continue. If you really want to stress that you're doing something after doing something else, again, we don't have that in the sentence A. You can add naso. Okay, we don't have that. Okay, now we have this usage where it doesn't have to be an action after another action. Okay, let's see. Simply connect two clauses with similar idea. Okay, I'm beautiful and I ate is also not a similar idea. So again, sentence number A still seems fishy. Okay. Okay. String together adjectives, also not the case. This mix from adjective and verb is really fishy for sentence A. When one action happens after another action. When connecting two clauses with similar idea. Yeah, both not the case here. In comparisons. Yeah, that's it. That's it for me. I don't need to read further. A is wrong because yeah, it's just not possible to use like to use an adjective and then an action afterwards. You cannot connect those two very different things with Go. So we go with A. Oh wait, I have this. Don't I have this text thing? Let's see. I guess I can reuse this. Oh my god. Now that I see this, those are the different ways you can say red. I will delete it very quickly, or it just annoys me. So 1A. Okay. Next. Which one of the following means I want to drive that car? I think my biggest strength so far in Korean is actually translating. Translating always seems easy because translating, I don't need to understand every single part of every sentence, but I can usually derive the translation from the rest that I understand from the context or so. So translating is good for me, in my feeling at least. So let's see. Okay, Chonin, Kichare, Wanada. I want that car. Okay. Okay, I want that car. I learned Wanada if you want objects. Don't say you want a girl or it's a very sexual meaning. I remember that. So a car is an object, so that's fine, but we are missing the driving part here. So this is just I want a car. I want that car. I want that car. So A is definitely not the sentence we are looking for. So let's go to B. Chonin unjon hago. I want to drive. We are missing the car. Also not the correct sentence. So this seems super easy to be honest. Chonin kichare unjon hesoyo. I drove that car. No. Chonin kichare unjon hagoshipoyo. Yeah, that's it. So this is super easy. Super easy. I hope it's. If this is not correct, I'm embarrassing myself here, but yeah, I'm pretty sure. I'm very, very sure. Okay, choose the incorrect sentence. Okay, here we don't have a sentence that we are looking for, so I have to translate every single sentence, which is good. Chonin jebe kago isoyo. I'm going home. Go itta is progressive form. Ka is obviously to go, so I'm going to the house, I'm going home. So this is I'm going home. Seems correct from the first look of it. Chonin chare unjon hagoi isoyo. Hago isoyo. I'm driving car. I'm driving the car. I am driving the car. Okay. Could be fine, ja. Chonin hakgyoe sogoi isoyo. So, what is so again? So, I to school. So da. To stand. To stand. So da is to stand, right? I'm pretty sure. I'm standing. I'm standing in the school. Seems incorrect because I learned positional verbs like to sit, to stand, to lie. They describe a state, and for states you are using ita as well, but you use a ita or o ita and not ko ita. So first feeling, this is wrong. It should be Chonin Hakyoe Soita. So isoyo, without the go. So isoyo. Because it's not an active action, it's a state. Okay, so that's my thought about number C. Now let's check number D. Chonin Pabil Mogoso. I'm eating. Okay, it's number C. Do you agree, Flo? Ah, that's another. I do not think so. I think it would be possible, but I think both are definitely correct. Because I think this ESO, that's this part, an action is being done inside of a place, but standing is not really an action that is being done. To stand is like a state. So that's why I thought ESO is not needed. And that's also why I saw, why I think go is not needed. So I will actually, you know what? I will actually put the correct sentence here. Maybe we get it. Oh wow, okay, that's not Korean. Okay, Chonin. Damn it. C. Now brackets. And now Korean language enabled, and now we can write the sentence. Hakgyoe so isoyo. Okay, so this is what I think. Can I add something here as well? No, these are number two were all correct sentences, but we're just looking for that specific part. And number A is, yeah, number A we can add information to answer number one, 1A. Not action after action or similar meaning. I know it gets a little bit big, but one second, I'm fixing it, I'm fixing it, all good. Okay. So now I have just the answers here, and when we check the answers later on, I can just enable this part at the bottom there, and that has the reasoning or some additional information about the answer. Okay. Yes, I looked up a few sentences, and so is both fine. Yeah, it's both fine, but I don't think you have to use ASO. Okay. Choose the incorrect sentence. Chonin nalshire chu wo. Okay, this is weather, but I don't know what this is. Chup. Okay, we can think about this. So this one is probably an irregular coming from a B from this one. So it's chupda, which means to be cold. And then it's a compound. The O is a compound word connector. And it gets. No, wait, is it? Yeah, it is. It could be. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. No, it's just to be called. That's a word I recently learned, to be called. Chu. Chiosoyo, chiosoyo. Chu wojida. Chupta plus passive. Passive, you say. Okay, interesting, yeah. Passive. Passive and past tense. So I think the meaning is the weather's cold or was cold. But I don't understand the passive there. It's a progress. Hi, red, blue, green. A progress. Do you mean progressive? Because that's usually built with goita. This one is progressive usually, right? So I don't really get it here. It's not clearing up. Clearing up is kojida. Or it's. Is it become. No, becoming cold? No. Becoming cold is. No, that's not it. Really? It's becoming cold? Okay, let's check this. So I have this text box down here, and I would now just analyze this part and write down what building parts we have, which building blocks we have to build that sentence that we have here. So we have obviously Chupta. That's pretty obvious. Then we have, what else do we have? We have an O because it's uo. Then we have a G. We have a G. I think it's O G, yeah. Yeah, okay, I see. I see. And then we have just normal past tense. Yeah, and this one is basically okay. So cold passive past tense. Yeah, past is enough. So is this analysis correct? Those are the correct building blocks, right? Cold, passive. Sorry, becoming. That's what I mean. Becoming. Yeah. Okay. I guess that's it. Okay, so that's a correct sentence. So we continue. What else do we have here? Nalshiga chuo josoyo. Oh my god. It's basically the same. Wait, we have an I here. What? I? The weather became cold? Wait, that makes no sense. So I guess A is incorrect. Here, the weather became cold. It's fine. Here. The weather. Is becoming warmer. The weather is getting warmer. Progressive and become or get. And oh, here we have Chonin again. Tone. I hate warm or hot weather. Okay, I hate hot weather. The weather is getting warmer. The weather is became cold or got cold, I guess you would say. And this one is incorrect. Okay, so number 4A is the incorrect sentence and correct answer for the task. Which is the biggest thing? Kangajinin? Kangaji. That's puppy, right? Kangaji. Yangi? I have not learned mouse and lion. What? Ko-Yangi. Ko-Yangi is cat. Jui. Jui Boda. Saja Lion. Jui Mouse. Ah, wait. Jui, I learned it as red. Jui. Red. I think that's what I learned. Jui. 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 Puppy and cat. Rat, or I guess mouse then. More big. Yeah. What is Boda? It's then, right? dog and cat are bigger than mouse. Right? Is that the correct sentence? But where's the lion? The lion is just missing. And can you confirm that Bodar is then with an A? Nope. Okay. Yes. We have a problem here. I go with A? What? Your translate nope was too that sentence was not my translation was not correct. Dog and cat are more big than mouse. That is not correct. Cat and mouse, that's what I said, right? Oh, you ah, wow, yeah, right. These two are connected, not these two. But I have to say, yeah, so I see my mistake, but I can explain at least a little bit of it. I remember that in the grammar lesson, you can put the rang after the second noun. But in that case, I don't think this can be there. So I know it's possible to have two nouns and the rang is at the second one, but you still connect those two. That's definitely possible. But I guess then you don't have the nin. So in this part is puppy is more is bigger than cat and mouse. So, do we just say lion? Because lion is obviously the biggest animal, and we have no further information about lions here, so it's obviously just answer D. It's so weird that we have no information about lions here. So what kind of question is this? Yeah, I don't know. I guess I guess we are answering puppy. But I don't like the question. D should be the correct answer, but it will be A. Okay. Maybe Korean lions. The very popular Korean lion. Yes, we all know it. The good old Korean pet lions. Okay, what are you good at? Su Yong Mus Mote. I'm bad at swimming. Okay, bad at swimming. Okay, not true, but fine. I accept. Kung Bure. Jalaji Anna. We are not good at studying. Not good at studying. Bad at swimming, not good at studying. Okay. Hangugore. Oh, good at speaking Korean. Korean language. Do good. We are doing good. We are speaking, yeah, I guess speaking Korean well. So it's A. Yeah, number A. This one was super easy again. I mean, the previous one was also easy. I just fucked up. Okay, next. Finish the conversation. Nugurang Mogoso. With who did you eat? With whom did you eat? Proper English, I think. With whom did you eat? Yes, I ate. Or yes, I did eat. Makes no sense as an answer. Jom Shimil, I ate lunch. Makes also no sense. Omma wa mogoso, I ate with my mom. Makes sense, okay. I want to eat. Doesn't make sense. So it's obviously number C. Number C, letter C, obviously. Okay. Eight. Yeah, you can buy mask and socks and stickers and everything, yes. Yeah, not bad, right? Should I just buy some and then stream with that? Makes no sense. If I would do like real life streams where I go around outside, then it would make sense. It would fit if I do like a learning Korean outside stream. But I'm not doing that, so let's continue. Which one does not fit with the rest? Moi has so. What did you do? Moi sil, hey yo. Again, what did you do? What thing? What thing did you do? Oddon, which thing did you do? What did you do? What thing did you do? Which thing did you do? Why did you do? So I'm saying number D, letter D. 8D. So this is all what, and this one is why. Well, I guess this one is which, but you're asking about the thing. And this is asking about the reason. Okay, choose the incorrect sentence. Myot doni isoyo. This is not correct. This is how many money you have, right? How many, but how many money? Money should be how much. It should be olmana and not myot, right? Myot is only for countable things. But I mean, maybe in Korea or in Korean, money ca counts as countable. Maybe it's just a Korean thing that you can say this part, that you can say how many coins you have or whatever, right? How many one you have. We'll continue. But if you translate it to English literally, then it would be incorrect. You can't say how many money you have. But we will continue. If you can't, you can count the currency. You can count dollars, but you cannot count the word money, right? You can not say, I have five money. Makes no sense. You can say, I have $5, but not, I have five money. That's what I'm saying. That's the difference. In English, I'm not 100% sure if Koreans treat it the same way. So, yeah, that's just my thoughts about this, and now we continue. Myot Jan. What is Jan? Myot Jan. Mashiosoyo, to drink, past tense. Is this some kind of drink? How many bottles? How many glasses? Glasses counter. How many glasses did you drink? Ooh, that was a hard part in the grammar. This order of words: noun, number, counter, particle. But if you ask it in a question, it was another way around. Okay, so in a normal sentence, it's noun, number, counter, particle. Noun, number, counter, particle. That's a normal sentence. In a question, it is myot. Myot counter, noun particle. We have no noun here. I could, I don't know. I could definitely see it being correct. I think you can omit the noun. I mean, it's clear from the context, probably. How many glasses did you drink? Could be fine. So we'll continue with the next sentence. Yogiye, so here. Olmana. Jaju wayo. Here often come. How often do you come here? How often do you come here? Olmana for how? How often? Olmana jaju. I think that's fine. I think that's correct. You can use olmana in front of an adverb to ask to what extent that adverb is happening. I think that's fine. I takja nin olmayeyo. This table? How much is this table? Yeah, how much is this table? I think that's asking about the cost of the table. I think that's fine as well. So I'm going with number A. I'm going with A. What do you think, guys? This is one of the more difficult questions, I think, but I'm going with A. Because money is not countable. That's my answer. Yup. After Mjot only counters. Yeah, that would make sense. That would definitely make sense. Because everything that you can count has a counter. So that completely makes sense. So, yeah. Then it's A. Okay, very nice. When will you eat dinner? Omaga. Un hue. Un, what is un? After un. I know uhu. Is un noon? Is this afternoon? In the afternoon? I know afternoon as uhu. But this is unhu. But maybe this is something where you just split apart the two things, and this one is now a noun for noon, and this is an after the noon. Not afternoon as one word, but after the noon. Maybe it's still possible. Oda. It's Oda, it's to come. But why is an N there? Okay, I will continue to read the sentence and then we'll see. Okay, so after mother. This is a subclause. Okay, this is a subclause. This one is a subclause. And when this happens, this is a subclause indicating a time. This is a time indicator. So after mother has come, or after mother came, or comes. After mother comes. This is just plain form, normal plain form conjugation, right? Okay, we'll continue. Chonin, ja, Jonjok, evening, Jonik, Shiksa, evening meal. So dinner. Chonin, Jonjok, Shiksa, Mogil, Koyeyo. I will eat dinner. Okay, I will eat dinner after. Mother, after my mother comes. Yeah, this one. But is this just the normal plain form conjugation? Or am I, is this some, is the end some other grammatical concept? This is the only thing I'm not sure about. But it, the answer is B. Oh wow, big text. When using who after a verb, you do not add key to the stem. Why would you add key to the stem? Instead, you must add N to the stem of the verb. Okay, in what cases do you add key to the stem? Is it always in? So you always add key, except you have who. I will check the part myself. Where is it? Here. Oh, key John. Key John. Nhu. Okay. Let's see. Ah. Okay, so it's always Ki John. We learned this in 29, okay. And then it's, oh, we have, this was the only lesson with color. The only lesson where color was used. Interesting. And then for who it's N, okay. Okay, nice. Thanks. So let's, oh, last question, number 11. Choose the incorrect sentence. Amudo kuroge heyo. Oh, this kuroge, those this kuro, kurota and irota and so on. I'm not that comfortable with that. Okay, amudo, nobody. Yeah, it's number A. I can just say already it's number A. It's the incorrect sentence. That's it. Because we learned when you use nobody, you need to use a negative form of the sentence. You need to conjugate the sentence in a negative way. And this is just not here. So this is wrong. Here we have amudo and we have jianayo, which is fine. Here we have nothing. We have also negative form. And here we have nowhere, and we also have negative. So obviously number A is incorrect. So that's it. Oh, red, blue, green. Past tense, future, present. Oh yeah. Yeah, I remember when you said it last time. I guess that's the thing that we learn in lesson 29, which is coming the future. For now, I will remember it's Ki John and N Hu. N Hu. N is past tense. Yeah, Yeah, okay. I guess I can remember it. Nin is present. Okay. I can remember it. Yep. Okay, that's it. So let's compare the results here. Ah, we don't have any additional information, but we have the results. Whoops. Okay, let's compare. A, D, C. Where's my mouse? Okay, here. C, A, C, D, A, B, A. Easy. Kosu. Noise, nice. Okay. Yeah, nice. That was it. Test too hard. No. We don't have to go back. Okay, well, to be honest, I did go back for two questions, but mostly to really understand it. I already, with your help a bit as well, I already kinda guessed what the correct answer is in two cases. But I wanted to really understand everything around it. So that's why we went back sometimes. Unit 1 test. I highly suggest you take the Unit 1 test before you move on to Unit 2. Yes, we will do that. But if you really want on to move, no, I don't. Or you want to head straight to our next lesson? No, we will do the Unit 1 test. This one. This will be the test, and we have even three sections in this test. We have comprehension, we have grammar, we have listening. Wow. Listening test. Damn. Listening test will completely destroy me. Okay, but the plan is that we will first watch all the recap videos from the howtostudykorean.com YouTube channel. So let me open this very quickly. Okay, here we have it. So howtostudykorean.com YouTube channel. And working with my daughter is not the thing we are looking for. We are looking for the lesson recaps. And here we have all the lesson recaps until 32. Okay. So the plan is they are only like 3 minutes, 2 minutes. So they are very short. Okay, here 5 minutes sometimes. But overall, we should be able to do this in, I guess, in two. Yeah, here 7 minutes, 8 minutes. Okay, I think we need like 2 days for this. So we'll probably do like 15 in the first day and then the remaining 10 in the second day. We will do the recap videos from lesson 1 to 25. And after doing this recap, then we'll do the unit 1 test. And yeah, I think even if this lesson 17 to lesson 25 test went pretty well, I still think I need the recaps, especially for the listening part. If I'm seeing the letters, the grammatical concepts, if I'm seeing them written out, I can recognize them easier, but listening is a whole different story. I need to really know all the grammatical concepts so that I can ace the listening test. That's not my channel. No, that's not my channel. That's the channel of this website, howtostudykorean.com, of this website where I'm learning Korean. This is the YouTube channel. Not my channel. Okay, but yeah, that's the plan. So, the next 2 days, we will watch this lesson recap videos. We can preview one of them just to see what is waiting for us. Come on. Do it.
Cloud. Hey guys, Cloud here. Today we're going to be going over how to study Korean into six different and future lessons. The second.
So he's talking a bit and explaining the stuff, and he's putting it here on the, in the video
Part
as a
is the
graphic.
sentence word. To being I, Namja being.
I mean, we'll just go through the first five lessons. We'll just go through it on times two speed. Okay? So it will be very quick. Maybe we just need 1 day for those recap videos. But I think 2 days for the recap videos, and then we'll do the unit one test. So that's the plan for the next 3 days. Which day is today? We have a Wednesday. So Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So, that's the plan for the next 3 days. Recap video, unit one test. And yeah, then after, or in the end of this week, I'm an expert of Korean for unit one on how to study Korean.com. Okay, yeah, that's it. So I will stop the stream now, but I want to read this and answer this or talk about this. Yo, Starcast, did you think about putting the name of the casters into your thumbnail? I think that would be good. Red, blue, green. Do you enjoy the Starcast videos? Wait, were you here earlier, Red, Blue, Green? Did you see what Starcast told me in Korean earlier today? Okay, Red, Blue, Green doesn't know. You like some casters like Naoken and Scan, okay? There might be another caster that you really like in the future. Maybe in the very near future you will see another nice caster on the channel that you really like. That is obviously very much better than Naoken and Scan. No, but we'll see. Okay. Bye bye, Flo. Dodging the StarCraft content here. Okay, red, blue, green. That's what many foreign casters, foreign viewers ask. Do you think it's a good idea? Yeah, Cruiser, I wanted to talk about you about that anyways. But I guess we can do it on Discord and not here in my Korean learning stream. I have some suggestions for the like video description and thumbnail. But yeah, we'll talk about that on Discord. So that's it for my StarCraft for my Korean learning stream. So thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.